From the Home Slice News Center, this is the Daily Slice for Tuesday, November 28th, 2023. I'm D. Ray Knight. Amy Rose is on assignment. This is what's going on. Economic development groups that help fund Governor Noem's Freedom Works Here campaign say that they're also doing the heavy lifting of recruiting workers to the state. Noem's office has touted a trend of politically motivated individuals, many of them at or near retirement age, who have helped boost South Dakota's population by seeking more lenient tax structures or escaping what they perceive as heavy-handed COVID-era policies. For South Dakota businesses, however, skilled workers between the ages of 25 and 35 are who they would like to attract as the state's unemployment rate hovers at 1.9%, with about 20,000 open jobs. They say the process of trying to persuade younger workers to take a job in South Dakota is a painstaking one and goes beyond politics. The trial for a Spearfish man charged with murder began yesterday. Drew Rogers is accused of shooting and killing his wife, Destiny Rogers, at their home in January of 2022. He is charged with first-degree murder, along with several drug and weapons charges. Rogers has pleaded not guilty. The prosecution will not be seeking the death penalty if Rogers is found guilty. Doctors are warning of the triple threat of COVID-19, the flu, and RSV overlapping as winter approaches. Health officials are recommending the latest RSV vaccine for those at risk this season. It's a potentially dangerous, highly contagious virus that can cause respiratory disease. Very young children, people over the age of 60, and expectant mothers are the most at risk for RSV. The typical RSV season is from October through March. In news from the nation and the world, a truce between Israel and Hamas has entered its fifth day, with the militant group promising to release more civilian hostages to delay the expected resumption of the war. Israel is under growing pressure to spare Palestinian civilians when it renews its offensive. The sides agreed to extend their truce through Wednesday, with another two planned exchanges of militant-held hostages for Palestinians imprisoned by Israel. Hamas and other militant groups are believed to be holding enough captives to extend the truce potentially for 2 weeks. Israel has repeatedly vowed to resume the war with full force to destroy Hamas once it's clear no more hostages will be freed. A man pleaded not guilty to attempted murder Monday in the weekend shooting of three college students of Palestinian descent in Vermont. The attack is being investigated as a possible hate crime. The three young men were shot and injured Saturday while walking near the University of Vermont campus. 48-year-old Jason Eaton was arrested Sunday and made a brief court appearance from jail Monday. He's charged with three counts of attempted murder. The U.S. Justice Department and state officials are also investigating whether the shooting was a hate crime. Protests and tensions have escalated in the U.S. as the death toll rises in the Israel-Hamas war. Nikki Haley says former President Donald Trump causes too much chaos to be successful in a second White House term. She reiterated her argument about the GOP frontrunner at a large town hall on Monday in her home state of South Carolina. The former governor and United Nations ambassador drew the largest crowd of her primary campaign so far as she tries to close the gap with Trump just weeks before the Iowa caucuses kick off the Republican nominating calendar. Haley says the time is right for a new generation in U.S. leadership. Your weather forecast from the Home Slice Weather Center. Lots of sunshine today in 55. Low tonight, 28. And that was your Daily Slice for Tuesday, November 28th, 2023. The Daily Slice is a production of Home Slice Media Group, hosted by D. Ray Knight with Amy Rose. Executive producer Mark Houston. Engineered by Chris Jaques. I'm D. Ray Knight. Have a great day.